Hello, my name is Kelli Green, and when I hear the word leader, the first images that pop into my mind are of people. People who have shown me great examples of leadership and who have helped develop me into a leader as well. So I think of my pastors who have shown me what it means to be selfless. They invest so much time in me and our congregation in developing people and empowering them in ministry, in actively listening and seeking understanding. I think of one of my favorite college professors who identified strengths in me and encouraged me in those strengths and put me in situations where I had to utilize my strengths and step outside my comfort zone so that I could grow. She has this passion for investing in future generations. I think of my dad, who is the most hardworking man I've ever met. He approaches every situation with some grit, his hands wide open, and a servant heart, just wanting to be used in a way that betters our world for God's kingdom. He has this gift for seeing the big picture and thinking of how we can use our resources to serve people, to work for the common good. He has always taught me that to whom much is given, much is expected, and privilege should not be viewed as implied status, but as responsibility. And I think of my mom, who is welcoming and accepting and has this gift for radical hospitality. Most importantly, I think of Jesus, who came not to be served, but to serve, who hung out with the poor and the marginalized when society said throw them away on the curb. He just flipped everything upside down, and he loved in a way that we will never be able to fully comprehend. So when I consider my own perception of leadership, my own definition, I hope to combine all of these characteristics of the leaders who have invested in me, who have poured into me, and be able to pour out into others in that way. I recognize my own strengths because I'm a big Gallup Strengths Finder nerd, as positivity, adaptability, woo, or winning others over, achiever, and communication. And these strengths fall under the realms of influencing and relationship building. And so when thinking about how to collaborate with others in ministry, I recognize that when put in a situation with new people, I love meeting new friends. I love finding commonalities. I love understanding how we can grow together. How can we learn from each other? How are we different? What can we bring to our table so that we can be better in community and grow alongside each other? When recognizing how to engage with the gospel, I'm excited and most importantly, just passionate about Jesus. I recognize that my strengths allow me to influence others, but really all I want to influence others with is the most important message of the whole world, to love deeply as Jesus did and to model my life after his actions and to share that love with all people, knowing that all are welcome and not putting any restrictions on that. And that's one of the challenges and opportunities that the ELCA is facing and will continue to face is we're not a very diverse church. And that excites me for opportunity to grow. Most of my growth facilitating relationships in college were with those of different backgrounds than myself. I learned so much from students who were studying here from Southern Africa. And students from inner city Chicago, where I'm not from, as I'm from a rural upbringing and an agriculture background. And it excites me to learn from those different to me and to use my strengths of welcoming and encouraging and being flexible to adapt to different people, to learn how we can serve one another, and to not stay in a rigid way. I recognize that I have not been ELCA Lutheran my whole life. My family joined the Lutheran Church in our small town at a time when grace was not abounding in our current congregation. People were more concerned with judging others than following the life of Jesus Christ. And so it excites me to welcome others into a church, not in an imposing way, but in a grace-filled, you are welcome here way. I recognize also that there's a big gap in how many pastors are available and how many churches need pastors. I still remember the day when Pastor Rhonda sat me down at a coffee shop and said, "Kelli, I see a future for you as an ordained pastor." And I thought, what? I've never heard that before. No one has ever mentioned that to me. And I want to be able to encourage others and identify other strengths so that they feel empowered in ministry to serve in whatever way God calls them. I'm almost out of time, but I am excited to serve, passionate about Jesus, and thankful for the opportunity to lead.